Good morning, y'all.
Good morning, Father.
The Mass this morning is offered for the repose of the soul of Ann Hartman. Just because I come out at the strike of the clock doesn't mean I'm German, but I am. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with y'all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to lasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you
thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King,
O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ,
only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of God, Father, have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who give constant increase to your church by new offspring, grant that your servants may hold fast in their lives to the sacrament they have received in faith. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to my words. You who are children of Israel, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore, my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh, too, will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you, about the patriarch David, that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus, of this we are witnesses, exalted at the right hand of God. He poured forth the promise of the Holy Spirit that he received from the Father, as you both see and hear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Keep me safe, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup, you it is who hold fast my lot.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
I bless the Lord who counsels me, even in the night. My heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Therefore, my heart is glad, and my soul rejoices. My body, too, abides in confidence. Because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. You will show me the path to life, fullness of joys in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever.
Chief priests assembled with the elders and took counsel. Then they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers, telling them, you are to say, his disciples came by night and stole him while we were asleep. And if this gets to the ears of the governor, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble. The soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has circulated among the Jews to the present day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord
Jesus Christ.
Well, we are in the octave of Easter, 8 days of celebration to Christ has risen. It is a wonderful thing. And he says, do not be afraid, or St. Paul II, do not be afraid. So there we are, not being afraid, moving forward, but we had Lent, and it was like 6 weeks, 42 days, we had 40 days, we had nothing but fasting and prayer, almsgiving, we did the stations of the cross, we said extra prayers, we did all these penance things, and all comes, we're waiting for Easter to come around, and yesterday Easter came, and boom, now there's nothing else to do. So we're just blah, and it's like, well, what we heard the first reading was Pentecost, you know, when Peter stood up and spoke to the people in town. But it was 50 days after Pentecost, 50 days after Easter. So until then, do we have to wait? Well, just the gospel gives us a clue. The women came and embraced Jesus when they saw him on the road back home. He says, tell my brothers to go to Galilee. Basically, what it's saying, go back to where you came from. And there, wait. So this is what God tells us to do. Go back to where you come from and then start living there. But live in the joy of the resurrection. Know that I'm waiting for the right moment to come to you, and then we're going to start the mission which we had planned to accomplish. And you didn't know about the mission? Well, surprise, my father had the idea, so I'll let you know what the mission will be. And then you start to live with the expectation, the joy of the resurrection. The joy is such a wonderful thing. Just picture this. In olden days, way old, the people didn't know any God like we do. They made gods because they saw, ooh, there's a lightning coming down, must be the lightning god, let's worship him. Or maybe there was a mammoth killed one of the mammoths, says, oh, the mammoth is a lizard, let's worship the mammoth. Whatever came about. And so anything they didn't know, just imagine there's no police, there's no soldiers, that kind of thing. They're just at home somewhere in the country and they hear noises outside and they huddle together. What is it? Is maybe a god coming and trying to destroy us? And they totally frightened and fearful. And so now Jesus comes around and teaches us there's a God. He made everything. So don't be afraid of things of the world. Don't be afraid of people, because my Father never made them too. Be afraid of him who can destroy. And then he shows us the message of the of which he had. He says, follow me. Don't give in to the world and Satan and flesh. Don't do that, but follow me and I will give you a new place in my kingdom. So this is the good news. The good news that we don't have to be afraid of anything, nothing, because everything is in the plan of God. Doesn't God hold us in hand? In his hand we are safe, no matter what comes. Even if we should forfeit our lives by an accident, don't worry. If you're in a state of grace, you're in the hand of God. Doesn't matter what. How many ladies give away their life when they give birth? Countless numbers of them. They were in the hand of God, but God ordained it. So it is nothing more important than just doing the will of God as God asks us to accomplish. And today he just asks us, go back home and start living, but start living with me in the joy of the resurrection. And when we do things, God starts doing it, beginning today. Everything we do, we drive the car, says, Jesus, come with me, let's go on the ride. Come back home, Jesus, I'm hungry. Hungry too? Let's go and make some breakfast. And so you start incorporating Christ into your whole day so that Christ is always there with you. And you let him know what you feel, what you think, what you would like to have happen, but you're talking with him. And then when you're quiet in between, then listen, and he will talk to us too. It's simple as that. The spiritual life is not very difficult. Otherwise, only just very few people would attain it. Spiritual life is nothing but open ourselves to the grace which God wants to bestow upon us. It starts with baptism, confirmation, and then living out that calling. You might not be called to go to the missions, but yet we can pray for the missions. There's a lot of things which you can do spiritually, but not physically. And so by through Christ, all of a sudden, everything will be touched. Even things of the past. You can remember the past, the good or the bad things that happened, and then ask God to pardon the sinful things and bless those who are good. So you can go back in time, you can go forward in time. You're just not a single spot here in this one-time earth. You have the power now to help save everything and everyone. That's what the mission is, which we have. Because God sent Jesus into the world to do that, and he gave us the power. He said, help me save the lives of people, not physical lives, but spiritual lives. And so today we rejoice. So Lent is over. We have now a greater, bigger mission ahead of us, a joyful mission, because we start to live with the resurrected Christ. Father Almighty, we come and pray today for all our needs. We thank you for giving us your Son, Jesus Christ, and we thank you for taking him back home. We ask you now, be with us and help this country to be resurrected as well. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the even greater miracle of people who are in sin. Help them to find to be resurrected in Christ in an order of grace. We pray to the Lord. Pray for the suffering and hurting and those who ask for our prayers. We pray to the Lord. And any petitions we have. For these intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, we don't know how to express it rightly, but we love you, and we ask you to be with us now as we ask all things in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, have become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
Accept graciously, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, even Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is a true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
This week we use Eucharistic prayer number 1, the Roman Canon. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Benedict XVI, our Pope Emeritus, Donald, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. And Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or the offerings for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and pay their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, you blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for those to whom we have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased to God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so it become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us.
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, O Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to you glorious majesty from the gift that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. And also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with the holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom we continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Serious command and form the divine teaching, we dare to say.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now
and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
Let us pray. May the grace of this Paschal sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, Lord, and make those you have set on the way of eternal salvation worthy of the gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God be with you.
Amen.
As ascend, go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
I I
Divine praises. Blessed be God.
Blessed be His holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be His most sacred heart. Blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus and the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be your holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be your glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, the most chaste spouse. Blessed be God, His angels and His saints.
May the heart of Jesus in the most blessed sacrament be praised, adored, and loved with grateful affection at every moment in all the tabernacles of the world, even to the end of time. Amen.